Bangkok City. Hello again, everyone, and welcome to the ABL as we move along to the playoff semifinals action from the OCBC Arena right here in the Lion City of Singapore. Today, the third seed and defending champion Hi-Tech Bangkok City take on the second seed Singapore Slingers. Now, there won't be any surprise between these two teams as they aren't strangers, having met four times already, splitting all four games, each team taking the scalp of the other team at their own place. As we look at the standings, now these are the regular standings for the season. Westport Malaysian Dragons on point difference win the league 16-4. Singapore Slingers right there also, followed by Hi-Tech Bangkok City, the defending champions, we said 14-6. Saigon Heat wrapping up the fourth and final playoff position at 9-11, followed by Mono Vampires at 3-17, and the Filipina MX3 Kings at 2-18. And there you see a shorthanded Hi-Tech Bangkok City team without their star local player, Dasim Wadapong, and without Tyler Lamb. Now, the good news is they were able to find Patrick Kabahub, who played last year, the 6'1 guard, as we look at the game from last week. Some highlights from the Saigon Heat Slingers game. Look at Arnold knifing through two defenders. Acrobatic shot by him on the assist from Williams. Long outlet pass from Howard to Alexander. Alexander with a heck of a game last week. Woo! Starting to find a range again like he did a few weeks ago when he was most valuable player in the league. The follow there by Williams, he had a good game as well, but not enough of that. David Arnold and Williams could not carry the whole load for the Slingers. Meanwhile, balancing their attack, and quick on the go right there on the outlet pass. 100-73 final score in favor of the Slingers as they wrap up the final game of their regular season. Again, going 16-4. Now playing the first round of the playoffs, the semifinals, best 2 out of 3. Now if the Slingers should win this game, they will go to Bangkok for game 2. And should Bangkok win there, well, we'd be right back here again next Sunday for a game 3. So a lot of permutations. If the Slingers should lose today and then go up to Bangkok and lose, it is all over. Their season is done. Of course, it could end up the other way too. The Slingers will win today and go to Bangkok and win. Then it would be over, and the Slingers would have to patiently wait for the winner of the Saigon Heat Westport Malaysian Dragons series. So lots to play for today. The Slingers, their highest finish in a long, long time. The crowd still filing in here, as one might expect, a very good crowd in the making here at the OCBC Arena. Hello, everybody. Chuck Schreiner with you. Well, it has been a long grind of the season for both these teams, and this is what they all play for, the playoffs. Who will be the champions of the ABL? Will it be the defending champions, Bangkok Hi-Tech City? Will it be the upstart Singapore Slingers or the Westport Dragons, again, who are doing battle with the Saigon Heat? By the way, that game was played game one last night in Malaysia. A game one win, a closely fought contest until the fourth quarter, and Saigon couldn't keep up with the pace. So the Malaysian Dragons take the 1-0 lead on the merit of their 84-68 win at home last night. So they lead their best of three playoff series 1-0, and this is game one here. As we said before, as we look at the lineups, Hi-Tech Bangkok City will be without a couple of their star players. They'll be going with Goldstein. Donai Konkum gets the start today instead of Lamb, and there is Kabahug, Patrick Kabahug. Now remember, he was with the team last year. Him and Kanata had a duo going with them last year, but Kabahug coming back this year because of the injury to Lamb. Christian Charles, he was the most valuable player in the league last year. This year, in fact, the last game against the Slingers, he had 26 points, 21 boards. Stephen Thomas, 15 points, 9 boards. So no doubt about it, Bangkok will try to press their advantage down low and will be dumping the ball down to one of their two bigs time and time again this evening. There are the Slingers right there. Justin Howard, it will be his job to try and contain the two big guys as much as he can. Delvin Goh, coming off a good game he had last week against Saigon. Can he replicate that same performance against a very, very talented group of players in Charles and Thomas down low? He wasn't able to do it a couple of weeks ago in February when they met, but things can change, and Delvin Goh's game certainly has improved this year, especially around the basket and his footwork. Can the guards from Singapore pick up the slack? Can they attack the basket? How about in transition? So many questions are going to be answered in game one. Be starting in just a little bit, and again the crowd still streaming in here, and it is a good looking crowd here, and why not? There is Thomas. We were talking about him a little bit earlier, so the weight falls on Patrick Kabahub, the 6'1 guard, to see if he can fill it in for Lamb, who had 15 points and 4 assists. Very athletic player that they had lost, but he is gone for the season, as is their local player, Dawson Wadapong. He had 10 against Singapore the last time out and had 3 assists as well. So a couple of very, very important players missing from the arsenal of Bangkok. And we'll see how their replacements are able to pick up the slack for them. Singapore, no injuries to speak of. Of course, probably every player in the league is suffering some sort of aches and pains at this time in the season. But we're getting down to the business end of it. And any one of these four teams that are in the playoffs now are very, very worthy winners. Saigon Heat, very, very dangerous team, but they fell by the wayside last night, so they go down on a whole 0-1 against the Westport Malaysian Dragons. So waiting for the two teams to get last-minute instructions and come out on the court. And we will be underway in just a moment as we look at the refereeing crew here from the ABL. Probably the most surprising team this year would have to be the Slingers, and man, did they ever gel this year, especially their local boys, both Wu, Desmono, and Wong. Remember, Wong was not available last year, but he came back with a vengeance this year. He has been averaging over 12 points a game during the season. He served a 2-game suspension, but has been indispensable for the Slingers on his return. Local guys give the Singapore their intensity on defense. The best defensive team in the league, most think. If you look at statistics, that would tend to bear everything out. There is Delvin Goh pulling on his pants. So he will get the start this afternoon, and again, hoping that he can replicate that big game he had the other night against the Saigon Heat. That was on Sunday, February 21st. So everything to play for, no holds barred. Look for a very, very close game. These teams are very, very well matched, especially when you take into consideration the two players that Hi-Tech City is missing. So Singapore, we'll see if they can take advantage. All smiles right now, but I guarantee you in a couple of minutes it will be all business. Can Xavier McDaniel take advantage and slash and push his game to the rim like he's been doing successfully for most of the season? A lot of problems against Bangkok the last time they played. Of course, a lot of that was because of Lamb. He was so athletic, he would stop Alexander's penetration. There is the tip-off controlled by Bangkok. Number 6, Denai Kongkum gets the ball. Goldstein on the right-hand side being chased by off the dribble. No foul. Nice play by Delvin Goh playing defense against Thomas. Inlet pass inside. Reverse is no good. One and out. Chris Charles gets the rebound, and back comes Bangkok. So both teams 0-1. Goldstein almost losing it. Inside it goes. Kabahug, the fadeaway jumper is no good. Stepping inside the lane is Rosales. He gets it back. Little jump shot. Got it. So Chris Rosales opening up the scoring. Rosales, what a season he is having for Singapore. That shot from the elbow, he's been pretty much automatic there. Been averaging over 14 points a game the last 5 or 6 games. A little bounce pass inside. The follow is good. Nice job by Goldstein getting in behind his defender. Running the baseline and getting that little rebound and putting it back up and in. Alexander now with the ball, getting around his defender, back outside. Goh will take that shot. Little hesitation move is no good. Rebound by Thomas, off and running is Goldstein. Down the right-hand side, the return pass. Nice job by Alexander to get a hand in there and deny number 6, Denai Kongkum, again, who got the start because of couple of injuries to Dawson Wadapong. If you're waiting to see him, he is out with an ankle injury. Don't know if he'll be back the next game or not. Out of bounds it goes, and last touch by number 9. That is Kabahub. So a turnover, so Singapore will get it back. 2-2 just underway here. Chuck Schreiner with you at the OCBC Arena. So happy you could join us. Rosales to Alexander. See if Alexander can exploit his mismatch on that side. What do we have here? A charging foul. Who will that go against? I believe it's Desmond O, number 2, pushing underneath. see who they give that foul to. Yes, it is Desmond O. O trying to clear away space inside, so go down as a turnover for Singapore. Stepping up to get the ball is Dunne. Dunne looking right, now gets the ball inside. Goldstein, the ball rolls out of bounds. So another turnover for Bangkok. And again, this is a problem when you have to mix up your lineup for whatever reason. Everybody trying to get on the same page sometimes takes a little bit of time, a couple games, but Bangkok don't have that luxury. Around the screen goes Alexander, loses the ball. Picked up by Howard across the lane. Tough rebound there by Charles. Gets it off in the open court over to Goldstein. Goldstein down the left-hand side. Gets a screen. Waiting for numbers. Charles fighting Howard inside. Go fighting Thomas. Another play by Go. Nice job by him. And a little fadeaway by Chris Charles against Delvin Go. They did the switch very well, did Thomas and Charles. So Go ends up with Charles. And that's a mismatch that Charles will win most times. Here comes Alexander now. Man-to-man defense being employed by Bangkok. Go on the left-hand side waiting for a cutter. Here comes Rosales. Now Alexander looking for the little lane. Ducks his head, gets the ball over to... Oh! Rattles it home. Let's see if that's a three. It is. So Desmond O, just what the doctor ordered for him. He's been in a little bit of a shooting slump lately. 5-4, Slingers lead. Pass down low. Oh, going against Goldstein and an offensive foul. So Goldstein, that will be number one on him. So both these teams coming out super aggressive to start, as one might think, given the fact that it's a playoff game. There's Coach Neo there. Back comes Rosales and company. Rosales gets it off to Alexander. Now swings it over to Desmond Go. Popping up his O. O looking for the cutters. It's Alexander. He gets the ball. Mismatch with Kong Kong, and what do we have here? A foul, and the foul will go, I believe, on number six. That would be Nae Kong Kong. So that'll be one on him, and that is a matchup that the Slingers will be watching very, very carefully. They probably think they have the advantage on that. The athleticism of Lamb and the physicality of Wadapong will be missed by Bangkok. Inside look, Howard bumping up against Thomas. Rosales from outside, misses that, mistimed jump there by Delvin Go. Now Goldstein down the left-hand side. Goldstein pops from outside, no good, but Thomas with the offensive board. Howard there, nice move, count, no, a traveling call. Let's see if they count that. I thought I saw a traveling indication, but it is going to be a foul on Howard, I believe. So yes, count that. I saw the referee make a traveling indication, but that must have been something else. Count the bucket, and Thomas at the line, a pretty good free throw shooter, as he proves again. 7-5 Hi-Tech at the 6:37 mark. Rosales coming back. He's got Alexander in front of him. Now Howard has his pocket pick, but a foul by Thomas. So Stephen Thomas, as Howard takes him way outside. So both big men with a foul right now. Don't want to pick up a second foul at this juncture, that's for sure. Rosales running up to get the inbound pass from Alexander. Now, swings it back, looking for cutters. Round one cutter, and good switching on defense by Bangkok. Alexander rolling to the basket, trying to find some space. Back outside it goes, no good. 24-second violation. Good interior defense by Bangkok. So, swinging the ball, sharing it well enough with Singapore, but the switching you could see by Bangkok causing problems in the interior for Singapore on offense. Oh, now working against Goldstein. Kicks it back outside to Kong Kong. Kong Kong and Rosales going at it. Kong Kong works around the back. Gets it to Charles. Charles has a mismatch there. Back outside. Somebody's got to be open. And what do we have? A traveling foul or call. Believe that'll be on Goldstein, so another turnover. Bangkok 7, Singapore 5, early days here. 5:57 to go here in the first quarter. Rosales swings it to Alexander. Oh, rolling off a one screen. Now Go providing the screen inside. Ogo kicks it back outside. Rosales with a shot. Good. Nice job. Dribble penetration by O. Kicking it back outside. The open man, Rosales. Catch and shoot, 7-7. At the 5:34 mark. Long pass inside to Thomas. He's doubled up immediately. Somebody's got to be open. It is number six, Konkum. Konkum now. Alexander working on him. Charles gets some space. Got it. So that is the separation that Thomas is so good at getting over Howard. Now Charles working on Howard down low, working real hard, getting the turnover. Back comes Goldstein. What do we have? A foul. I think that's going to go against Desmond. Oh, great job on defense at the other end by Chris Charles, working on Justin Howard, just denying him the ball, getting his hands to it, knocking the ball loose into the path of Goldstein, and off to the races he went. So checking into the game now will be Wong Wei-Leong. Desmond O to the bench. Knifing in between two defenders, and the loose ball picked up by Singapore. Alexander, two on one, rolls to the basket. He is fouled. Had that gone, it would have counted. Down goes Alexander. He will go to the line for two, I believe. Let's see. The foul will be on number nine, Kabahub. And a timeout going to be called by Bangkok. Not much to tell between both these teams at the break. 9-7, Hi-Tech in the lead over the Slingers here at the OTBC Arena. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Off the timeout, Chris Charles leading all scorers with 4 points. We'll check that. He is with four with Rosales. Rosales also with four for Singapore. Singapore not having any luck getting the ball inside. Great denial defense by Bangkok early on. The combination of both Charles and Stephen Thomas. Just contesting every pass inside, every entry pass. Off balance shot by Rosales is off the mark, but a rare offensive rebound for Singapore, and Howard will get it back outside to Rosales. Wong now will back it up a little bit. Out long three is going to be way off the mark, saved and off the body of a Bangkok player, but right into the hands of Charles, who corrals it. Back comes Goldstein and company. Hub and Wong going at it down low. You can see right there, post up move, back outside it comes, almost lost. Howard trying to get his hands inside. Charles rolling through the basket, off the mark it goes. A follow, yes. Nice job by Charles, not giving up on the play. So he's got 6 4-point lead now for Hi-Tech, their biggest lead of the game, 11-7. Rosales swings it around to the left hand side. Wong cuts through, ball in the hands of Go looking for movement. Popping outside is Wong. Wide open on the right-hand side is Howard. Looking for Alexander. Nothing there. He'll stop and pop from going across the lane. No good. Thomas will get the rebound. Back comes Bangkok. A little bit of momentum going their way now. Goldstein with the ball. Barking out signals. High post is number nine as Kabahub. Working up against Rosales. Gives him a little bit of space. Post up move. Now cross-court pass, dangerous, but follows up and good. From the left-hand side, that is number six, Denai Konkum. So 13-7, 6-point lead now by Bangkok. The ball shifted over to the right-hand side. Howard comes up to the high post. Ball knocked out of his hand, taken by Thomas. Back the other way comes Bangkok. Down the right-hand side, the ball knocked away, but Bangkok getting it back. Goldstein off the dribble, no good. And what do we have? A foul, late whistle. Who will that go against? If it's Howard, it'll be number two on him. Still on the floor is Charles. He'll finally get up. Let's see. Yes, that is two on Howard. My goodness. So Howard will not be able to be as aggressive. Similar to what happened last week against Saigon, Howard picking up two quick fouls. Quickly getting ready to check into the game will be number seven, Wu. Let's see who goes out. Delvin Go will go out. So Wu in. Wu, Wong, and Rosales. Howard and Alexander for Singapore. Charles fighting for position inside. Alexander now working on him. Back outside it goes. Thomas will go straight at Howard. Straightens up, ball off the mark, and Alexander with his first board of the game gets the ball past half court, rolls to the basket. Catch and shoot, yes. Rosales, his third bucket of the game, and it couldn't have come at a better time. Count that as two. 13-9 in favor now of Bangkok. And off the dribble again. In the game now is number 12. Baseline move, underneath it goes, reverses off the mark. Howard pulls down a board, over to Alexander. Back comes Singapore. And a foul, and the referee's calling this very, very tight indeed. Who's this foul on? Whoa, let's see if this is going to be on Thomas. No, it's going to be on number six, Denai Konkrum. I think that'll be two on him. Very, very impressive interior defense being put up right now by Hi-Tech Bangkok City. Both Charles and Thomas, very intense. Being aggressive every time Singapore tries to get the entry pass in. Denial by the two guys in green, the American imports at the line right now. Alexander, yet the score. What a game he had last week against Saigon. That has been his Achilles heel throughout this season at the free throw line. A couple weeks ago, he was 4 of 16, was the X-Man. Certainly one of the better players in the league, but they're having a rough time at the line this year. 1 of 2, that's about where he is. So 13-10, 3-point lead now for Hi-Tech City. Full court pressure by the Slingers. Number 12 is Lachlan. He had a good game against Singapore last time. The foul will go on Wong. They converge on Goldstein, both Rosales and Wong at the same time. Wong hits him with the body. So that will be one on Wu. So O with a couple, Howard with two. On the other side of the ball, number six, Konkrum with two. Normally Bangkok, a very reliable free throw shooting team. I believe they're number one in the league, in fact. So Goldstein, 1 of 1, ups the lead to 4. One of the things you know that these teams have been talking about, taking care of the ball. Playoff basketball, so critical. Rosales now. He cuts through, banging off the body of Charles. Howard back outside now to Wong. There's wide open look for Alexander. He'll shoot it. In and out it goes. Rebound by Charles. What do we have? Is that going to be another foul on Howard? If it is, that will be 3 on him. My goodness. Let's see. Yeah, Howard, that is 3 on him. He will have to get out of there. Bad break for Singapore, and it was a late whistle. So what a break now for Bangkok. Go will go in. Howard will go out. 3 fouls on him. Now look for Bangkok to pound the ball down low often. Got the first one. So 6-point lead now for Hi-Tech City. What a break they get. Justin Howard with 3 fouls. We'll see how long they will be able to survive with him on the bench. 1 of 2. So that changes everything for Singapore. A potent weapon on offense is now gone. And on defense, Bangkok ought to be able to be pretty freewheeling, forcing Singapore into pretty much being a jump shooting team. Inside it goes, trying to force it back out again. 3 on the shot clock, way off the mark. Rebound taken by Thomas. Outlet back over to Goldstein. Good ball moving inside to Charles. He'll work on Alexander. He's doubled up. Long 3 is off the mark. And out of bounds it goes. It'll be Singapore ball. So 3 fouls. That is the news for Singapore. They will be out without the services of Howard. Probably they would like to keep him on the bench for the rest of the half. Now whether that's going to be possible is another matter. 1:20 to go here in the first quarter. It's been all Bangkok if you just joined us. In fact, offensively, Singapore, with the exception of Chris Rosales, has been very, very, very lethargic on the offensive end. Alexander swinging it over to Rosales. Around the screen, he will go. Rosales now following the play. He's doubled up, trying to force a shot inside. The rebound coming to Charles. Very quickly back down the court. And Singapore, one thing they do have going for them is they've got a small, quick lineup in the game. But Bangkok can afford to be patient now. Dribble penetration is going to be off the mark. And the follow by Charles over the top of the Delvin Goh for an easy two. 18-10, 8-point lead now for Bangkok. Singapore only 10 points here in the first quarter. Delvin Goh looking for somebody. Alexander now, he will be double up. And you can see how far up both Charles and Thomas are. A jump shot's going to be way off the mark. The follow by Wong as he sneaks in off the baseline. So 18-12. Put back there by Wong. Charles getting the ball off to Goldstein. Goldstein working against Wong. Goldstein off the dribble, no good. Alexander rips down the board. Cookie down the court, he will go. 2 seconds to go and a foul. And let's see if that'll put Alexander at the line. So fortuitous run of events here for the Singapore Slingers. Only 1.4 seconds to go. Silly foul. But that will put the X-Man at the line, a chance to cut the lead to four. Neither one of these teams really lighten it up here in the first quarter. Playoff basketball, as you might expect, very defensive. X-Man hits the first shot. Nice looking crowd here. Biggest crowd we've had this season. Hoping against hope to get to stay with Bangkok until their big man Howard can get back in the game. And I don't think Singapore will dare insert Howard in until the third quarter. Howard, Alexander hits them both. So 18-14, and that will do it. The end of the first quarter, pretty much all Bangkok. They're getting it done down low. Singapore trails four at the end of the first quarter. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Second quarter action here at the OCBC Arena, 18-14. Hi-Tech Bangkok City over the Singapore Slingers. And the big news, Justin Howard on the bench with three fouls. So they'll have to do it without their most prolific scorer this year. Delvin Goh will try to pick up the slack. Rosales with 6 points leading the Slingers. And Alexander, the guy with the ball there with 3 points, all of them from the line, and they are denying him the lanes. He's not able to dribble, penetrate, and another foul. And that will go on number 13 from Hi-Tech, Piapong Piron, who's just checked into the game. Remember, the Slingers without the, or check that, Hi-Tech Bangkok without the services of Tyler Lam and Dawson Wadapong. So trying to scratch together a lineup that can be competitive. Well, they've done a very good job. As usual, a lot of the heavy lifting being done down low. Rosales off the dribble. Long three is going to be off the mark. Charles with yet another board. Just dominating underneath for Bangkok. They have five offensive boards already. Dumping the ball down low. Alexander working against Thomas. Kick back outside. Swings it over to the left-hand side. Goldstein with a long three. And off the mark it goes. Delvin Goh picking up the rebound for Singapore. So one and out. Quick outlet pass to Rosales. Rosales, one guy to beat. Gets underneath. Off-balance shot on the go. And good. Oh, my goodness. Chris Rosales on the run. Little fadeaway jumper off the glass, and Singapore gets to within two. Piron with the ball. Picked off by Alexander. Back the other way it goes. For the slam. 18 apiece. And a quick timeout is going to be called by Bangkok. Singapore playing inspired basketball without the presence of their big man, Justin Howard, have tied it up at 18. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. 18-18 off the timeout by Hi-Tech Bangkok City. And Singapore, with their usual intensiveness on defense, forcing a turnover. Alexander taking the ball away from Thomas and going the other way for an easy two to tie the game up at 18. So pretty much the work is on the block for both these teams. For Singapore, they're going to have to ratchet up their defense, and they're going to have to outquick Bangkok, who are without the services, remember, of Tyler Lam and Dasim Wadapong. Bangkok will try and pound the ball down low to Thomas and Charles. Now, without the services of Justin Howard, who's on the bench with three fouls, full court pressure by Singapore. Long three going to be jacked up there. It's going to be off the mark. Alexander, another board. He comes out of the crowd with the ball. Gets the ball over to Rosales. Rosales will slam up another three. Check that. That'll be a two. Chris Rosales, 10 points, has taken this game under his wing. Thomas. Be a foul on Alexander, I believe, as he turned. I think that'll be one on Alexander. Alexander with 5 points. So everybody on Singapore having to pick up the slack for Howard, who still sits on the bench at the 18, we'll check that, the 8-16 mark. Thomas at the line. Opportunity to tie it up here for Bangkok. Rattles the first one home. Chris Charles already with four offensive boards. As a category, we would expect Bangkok to win easily. They out-rebounded Singapore 13-8. Bangkok had five turnovers in the first quarter to Singapore's four. Neither one of these teams shooting that well. Wide open look, they're going to give Alexander that shot. He switches to the left hand. Back outside it goes to Goh, well out of his comfort zone. So one and out for Singapore. Back comes Goldstein and comes. The build-up on the left-hand side. Charles underneath now. Goes working on him. Rotation now to the right. Goldstein working against Wong. Quick snap pass to the left-hand side. And that'll be number nine, Kabahub. Remember, he's the guy that took the place of Tyler Lamb. Underneath, back outside it goes. Almost picked off. Wong now. Alexander passes up the shot. Wu trying to break free of his defender. Back on the other side, and Go is fouled hard, I believe, by Thomas. So if that's Thomas, that'll be two on him. Yes, it is Stephen Thomas. So Thomas with two now. Also, number six, Denai Concombe with two for Bangkok. So Go, 50% free throw shooter at the line, and all of a sudden, playoff basketball, these free throws becoming extremely important. Hi-Tech up by one with 7:20 to go here in the second quarter. Chuck Schreiner with you, hoping you're enjoying ABL playoff basketball here at the OCBC Arena in the Lion City of Singapore. Go hits the second one as well. So 22 apiece, just like we thought this game would be. Charles now, Go working on him. Full court pressure by the Slingers. Goldstein bounce pass down inside. Double team now on Thomas. Somebody's got to be open. Kabahug, another three, in and out it goes. Right into the path of Wong, who taps it over to Alexander. Back comes Alexander, has one man to beat. And Charles changes his shot. Now back at the other way comes Goldstein and company. Dribbling through traffic, wide open look. Long three, up. Off the cylinder and in it goes. Happy birthday, Janusuk. So Hi-Tech Bangkok City with a three-point lead. Sometimes it's better to be lucky than good. Off the dribble. Rosales, Alexander, wide open look. They're going to give him that shot, but he passes it up. A couple dribbles back inside and no good, but an offensive board by Wong, but he has his pocket pick. Now in the open court comes Goldstein off to the right. Another long three is up and off the mark. So Bangkok now becoming a more of a jump shot team, and really that is not their game. Need to be a little bit more patient, get the rock down inside to Charles and Thomas. Banging downstairs, a foul, and that will go on Goldstein. Wu, nice job by him. So for Goldstein, I believe that will be number two on him. Yes. So a couple of Bangkok players with two fouls now. Going to the bench will be Rosales. Desmond Oh back into the game. So Singapore trying to get it done with an undersized lineup, and Bangkok trying to withstand the ferocious defense being employed by Singapore. Trying to deny the ball down low to Charles or Thomas, and Singapore doing a pretty good job of it so far. Now a chance to get to within one. Again with Howard on the bench with three fouls at the 6:02 mark. One of two. So Bangkok up by a couple. Pressing the ball forward is Bangkok. Now off to Charles, right around Go. Hop step to the basket. Turn and shoot by Charles is off the mark. Alexander with another big board. Off the dribble he goes. Now over to Wu, right into the hands of Bangkok player, and a foul. I don't know what Wu was thinking here. He grabs on to number 30, Janusuk. Now let's see, is this going to be an intentional foul? If it is, it'll be two plus the ball. Oh my goodness, I think it is. So a mistake there by Wu. Thomas goes over to the bench and gets a towel. So opportunity here now for Bangkok to go up by four plus have the ball, missing the first shot of Janusuk, who hit a big three a little while ago. So with the absence of Wadapong and Tyler Lamb, the onus falls on the Hi-Tech Bangkok City bench to pick up the slack, and they've been doing a fine job so far. One of two. Now Bangkok will have the ball. So silly foul really by Wu, who stays in the game. Rosales on the bench now. Charles working against Go. Inside it goes to Thomas. Thomas working on Alexander. He picks up the double team. Long three, way off the mark. Rebound on the floor, picked up by Desmond Go. Gets it over to Wong, and the Slingers off to the races. Wide open look for the three, way off the mark, and back comes Bangkok with ball. Charles lurking around the left-hand side, and over the top it goes to him, and a foul. Who will that be on? Number seven, Wu, I believe. So fast and furious action here. Wu, that will be two on him. Check that. That'll be Desmond O, so he's got three. He fouled out of the game last week, did Desmond O, against Saigon. So Charles at the line. Couple of shots, misses the first one. Bangkok up by three. Very physical game, very intense game, as one might expect in a playoff. Singapore really, if they're going to have any realistic chance to win this series, has to have this game. One of two. So 4-point lead again now for Bangkok. Checking in the game will be Rosales. O will check out. Rosales, by the way, leading the Slingers with 10 points. In fact, leading the game with 10 points. Wong. Rosales waiting for movement. Back outside to Alexander, swinging it over to Wong. Wong looking for a screen. Go, thought about it. Rosales now is six on the shot clock. Becomes double team. Underneath it goes, and the ball is blocked away by Wu, and a 24-second violation. Steel curtain inside, Thomas on one side, Charles on the other, and that's just what happens. Once you do get the ball inside, you have to contend with that. And look at the size of Wu compared to Thomas. Thomas at 6'10", Wu maybe 6'3". So a turnover by Singapore at 4:51. Hi-Tech with a 4-point lead. They've led by as many as eight. Ferocious Singapore defense trying to shut it down. Full court pressure again. Alexander now go working against Charles, who momentarily loses the ball. Back over into the hands of Lockham. They reverse now. Now inside to Thomas. Thomas back outside. The rotation goes to number 30. Skine for the rebound is Alexander. Another miss by Janisuk. So they're giving the Bangkok team the outside shot. Alexander, he'll stop and pop. Yes! So Alexander with the two gets Singapore back to within two, 4:16 to go here in the second quarter. Obviously, the game plan for Singapore, keep it close. Charles Skine to get the rebound, but loses it. Wong comes out with the ball. Lead pass to Alexander. Alexander misses the layup. Now back the other way it goes. 5-on-4, opportunity now for Bangkok off the dribble, and a foul, and no. And that'll send Kabahug to the line. Well, Alexander at the other end missing the layup. Wong leading the fast break. So missed opportunity for Singapore. Let's see if Kabahub can clean it up. Remember, he was a member of this same Bangkok team last year that won the championship, him and Kanata. It's been a while since he's been in sync with this team, so he hits one out of two. He's got 3 points. This for the 4-point lead. So what do we have here? Checking out will be number 30, Janisuk. Back into the game will be Goldstein. Swings it over to the left inside. Wu now. Post up move by him. Back outside to Alexander waiting for movement. Swinging across to Wong. 8 on the shot clock. Wu well off the mark with that attempt, and could have done with another pass or two. Desmond O getting ready to come into the game, and Wu will check out. Ill-advised shot there by Wu Chin-De. So Singapore now will be forced to go back on defense. Quickly back up the court come Bangkok. Rosales, Charles working on go. Dump pass into Thomas. A little jump shot over the top of Alexander for two. Now a 6-point lead now for Bangkok. 3:09 to go here in the second quarter. It's been all Bangkok. You just joined us. Go with the ball way up top. Rosales looking for the screen and gets it. finds a little opening, but has to kick it back outside. Desmond O inside, and has the ball knocked away by Charles. Back comes the guys in green. They'll hold it up. Now this is much better for Bangkok. They've got Charles down low. Alexander working on him. That's a mismatch. Double team. Inside it goes. Last touch by who? Goldstein. So Singapore will get the ball back. Nice interior defense there by Singapore. Cutting out the lanes and immediately getting on their man as soon as the ball swings over to them. Wong now with the ball at the 2:30 mark. Singapore would like to get to within at least two before the whistle. Wong gets away. The little floater is good. Wong off the glass. Difficult shot. 31-27. The 2:14 mark. The ball stolen away by Rosales. Up and in. Another steal. So Singapore defense getting it done once again. A two-point game. Steal by Rosales. He's got 12. Dumped into Thomas. Alexander working on him. Shot is off the mark. Alexander with another rebound. Pass outside to Wong. Wong. Alexander back outside. Go. And he is fouled. Well, it looked like he might have walked with the ball, but a foul they're going to call. Let's see who they're going to give it to. If it's Thomas, that'll be three on him. It's going to be on Chris Charles, number 21. He can't believe it. So that'll be two on Charles. A timeout by Bangkok. They are clinging to a two-point lead with 1:47 to go here in the first half. Off the timeout, the foul on Chris Charles. That's his first foul, but more importantly, gives Singapore back the ball with 1:47 to go. A very close, intense game here. Hi-Tech 31, the Slingers 29. OCB Arena, and Delvin Goh will go to the line with a shot to get this game on level terms. He hit one of two his last trip to the line. Delvin Goh, a much improved player. Game he had last week against Saigon must have given him extra confidence because he has come out with a whole lot more of it here in this game, even though the pedigree that he is facing, Chris Charles, remember last year's MVP, misses the first one. Charles, probably the premier number five in this league right now, and Alexander and Goh with their hands full trying to cover both him and Thomas. Got the second one. So 1 point game. Bangkok with the ball. And plan going Singapore's way right now. If they can just keep it close. Wait for the second half and Howard will be available again for Bohug off the dribble. Swings it over. Inside it goes. Charles, nice catch and shoot. Oh, beautiful play by Chris Charles. Nice pass inside by Lockin. So Singapore down by three. Wong takes the ball over to the right side. Now Alexander looking for cutters. Back over on the left goes Rosales. Rosales, little stutter step in. Shot counted and one. Chris Rosales is unconscious. 14 for the little guy. One man wrecking crew for the Slingers. with Howard on the bench, they've needed every bit of it. So Slingers down by one, a chance to tie it up here with 1:14 to go. Does just that. So an even 15 now for Rosales, and back comes the full court pressure for the Slingers. One would have thought that without Howard in the game, Singapore would have been pretty much dead in the water. That hasn't been the case at all. Off the dribble now, again comes Lock-in, and a blocking foul by Rosales. So that'll be number one on him, and we'll send Bandit Lock-in to the line. He had a big game against Singapore. Remember the last time through, he hit a couple big shots. And that 9-point win for Bangkok when they were here last, I believe February, first week in February. Chris Charles showed that particular game, 26 points, 21 rebounds. Thomas, 15 points. So Lock-in fills it up for both of them, and 1:05 to go. Wong. Rosales down low. He'll run the baseline. Go looking for somebody. Rosales will put it up again, way off the mark that time. Going to the well once too often. Thomas with the easy rebound. Long pass downstairs to Charles, who corrals it. And got it in one. He will go to the line. Chris Charles would not be denied. That might be on Desmond O. So a 4-point lead now for Bangkok. See if that is on. Now they're saying maybe Wong. That would be two on him. So opportunity to make it a 3-point play. Very athletic move. That's two in a row for Chris Charles, just reaching up, corralling the ball. Can't hit the free throw. So 41 seconds, Alexander coming out of it with the ball. He's got Go on the left-hand side, forces the ball to the basket, knocked away. Last touch by Bangkok. Charles, in fact, with the block. So going straight at the interior defense. Thomas will go out of the game, so he doesn't pick up a third foul. Smart move by the coaching staff of Bangkok. Circling around is Rosales. Nice defense there by Lock-in. Wide open look for Alexander. He's not going to take it. However, Wong will. Another rebound for Charles. 22.5 to go. About a 1 second delay between shot clock and game clock. Bangkok can play for the last shot. Charles coming up to deliver the screen. Now another one. Downstairs it goes. The Rahug with the ball now. Post up move by him. He'll turn and fire. Going to be off the mark. Rebound by Alexander, and that will do it at the halftime. So 37-33, Bangkok with the 4-point lead. They dominate down low with the absence of Justin Howard, who sat out most of the game in the first half with three fouls. Singapore riding the hot shooting Rosales. Not enough, though, to overcome Bangkok. And that will do it at the end of the first half. We'll come back for second half action after this. Welcome back, everybody, at the OCBC Arena. First game of the semifinals playoff in the ABL. Hi-Tech Bangkok City 37, Singapore Slingers 33. The big news, first half, Justin Howard, of course, with the three fouls. He was held scoreless for the first time this season in the whole first half. To Singapore's credit, though, they kept the game very competitive and only trailed by four going into the second half. They did that on the back of the scoring by Chris Rosales, 15 points for him. The other side of the ball, well, as usual, Chris Charles going to town. 12 rebounds, including three offensive boards. Total of 13 points. Charles always seems to have a big game against Singapore. No exception today. Remember, Hi-Tech Bangkok City without Dawson Wadapong and Tyler Lamb. Filling in is Patrick Kabahub. He's had 5 points, so good job by him to fill in. But Singapore, let's see if they will start. Yes, Howard is on the floor, but look for Bangkok to go straight at him to try and get another quick foul on him, put him back on the bench. So Howard will have to pretty much let Charles go right by him. Goldstein being watched by Wong. Thomas back outside. Goldstein, a long look at the three, fills it up. So 40-33, 7-point lead now by Bangkok. Right behind the screen provided by Thomas. Wong over to Desmond O. Howard breaking out, gets the ball. Around the horn it goes, popping up off the screen as Wong off the dribble. Alexander looking to get inside, he does, and rebound by Howard up and in. His first points of the game. Nice job by Justin Howard. Getting position over Thomas. So 40-35, 5-point lead now. Goldstein still working on Wong, be looking for either Thomas or Charles. Another three put up, rebound on the floor now. Who's got it? Desmond O out front to Wong. Bounce pass on the opposite side. Rosales can't, oh yes, up off the cylinder and in. Well, turnabout fair play. We saw Janusuk get one like that earlier for Bangkok. So 40-37, 3-point lead now. Abahog with the ball. Little skip pass over to Thomas. Turning and firing. Howard with another rebound. Singapore in the open court getting the ball to Alexander. Now giving the ball off to Howard up and in. Nice job. Good telepathy going between Alexander and Howard. So now a 1-point game. Howard coming back into the game with a vengeance. His second basket. Charles dumps it down to Thomas. He's doubled up and the ball thrown out of bounds. Well, you can see the double team and somebody hurt on the floor there. Who was at us? Rosales shaking his finger. I hope he's okay. What a disaster it'd be if they didn't have him. Chris Rosales looked like the ball might have smashed up against his finger a little bit. Now he's got the ball. Looking for Wong. Wong thought about it. Drives inside and is fouled hard. And that will go on Goldstein, I believe. And if it is, that'll be number three on him. So very quickly, the complexion of the game changing. That is three, yes, on Goldstein. Talking to the referee right now. See if they bring him out of the game. They will not. So at the line, a chance to tie it up here will be Wong. Singapore wasting no time here in the second half, going to Howard. And again, letting their defense do their talking for him with the strip. Back the other way and getting the foul on top of that. So Goldstein now joining Howard with three, and overrunning it is Howard. Now Goldstein with it. Quickly getting down the court, switches hands. Now inside to Charles, back outside. Goldstein will take another three and he'll fill it up again. His second triple of the half. So 43-40, Bangkok back up by three again. Well, if that third foul bothered him, you wouldn't have known it. Alexander rotating the ball to the left over to Wu, who's checked in. Now off the screen goes Wong. Alexander throwing another one. Six on the shot clock. Alexander wide open look on the jumper, no good. The ball skittles out of bounds and it will go the way of Bangkok. Let's see, the referees conferring who will get the ball. talking over there. One of the referees said Bangkok ball. The other one not so sure. So jump ball, they're going to say, and possession arrow will go the way of Singapore. So a break for the Slingers here. They get the ball back. This game has lived up to expectations and then some. A defensive titanic struggle. Singapore wide open look here for Alexander again. And oh, off the top of the, no, they're going to say it went over the top of the standard. No good. So no basket. Hit the top of the standard and bounce back into the cylinder. You can't do that. So Alexander, a couple of kicks at the can on that possession. Nothing to him. Here comes Goldstein. He's got the hot hand now for Bangkok. 6 points here in the half. Working on Wong. Off the dribble. Dumps it into Charles. Howard working on him. Back outside it goes. Good rotation. The ball hug with the three. 6 point lead now for Bangkok. And the little guy who had 23 points against Westport, Malaysia last year in the finals, filling it up again for Hi-Tech Bangkok City, his former team. Timeout being called by Singapore. They're going to have to get some hands in the faces of the shooters here in the third quarter. 6 point lead by Bangkok off the timeout. Off the timeout, hot shooting by Fred Goldstein. He's got a couple of triples, and add to that, Patrick Kabahub, he chips in with a three as well. So 9 points off of 3-pointers for Bangkok. They were 2 of 10 in the first half. Singapore 1 of 7. So they stretch the 4-point halftime lead to 6 points here at the 6:47 mark. Howard coming back with a vengeance. 4 points for him off the half. Remember, he's playing with three fouls, as is Goldstein. Nothing to pick from these two teams at this point. Again, living up to expectations. Wong swinging the ball over to the right. Back outside again. Desmond Oh now, who has checked into the game for Wu. Howard now at the high post. Alexander has the open look. They'll give him that shot. Now trying to dribble inside. The follow by Howard is good. Off the miss. So Thomas and Charles get isolated on the same side of the basket, and Howard able to step in for the easy two. 46-42 now. Goldstein off the dribble. Oh, yes. Nice little 180. The ball blocked. Who else? Alexander. Lead pass to Desmond O. Goes straight to the basket. And a foul. And O down on the floor. See who they're going to give that foul to. Goaltending they're going to call. So no foul. So 2 points for Singapore. They'll employ their full court press once again. Nice job by Desmond Oh going straight to the basket. The Bahug gets the ball over to Goldstein. So that 6 point lead is gone. Another steal by Singapore. Alexander again with the ball. He's got Oh on the right hand side. He gives it off to Rosales. Rosales, hesitation move inside and drops the ball. Kabahug picks it up. Back the other way it goes. Charles underneath. Blocked away by Alexander, but he's going to get called for the foul. So foul on Xavier Alexander, and I think that'll be two on him. Check that one. Well, that's going to be on Wong. And that will send Charles to the line. Well, golden opportunity there for Singapore. They got the steal. Had a three on two. Desmond Oh passing up the shot instead, giving the ball to Rosales, who found the lane and dribble penetrated, but Bangkok recovering in the interior and nowhere to pass the ball to. The ball on the floor and Bangkok back the other way. Charles missing the front end of two. 5:36 mark. One of two for him, so a three-point lead now for Hi-Tech Bangkok City. Rosales to Alexander. Out pops Desmond O. Howard, Thomas all over him. Rosales. Back over to Alexander. Charles. Howard will take that little shot. Yes! Justin Howard making up for lost time. Quickly has 8 points. And Singapore to within one. Charles off the dribble. Rotates inside. Gets it to fall. Nice play by Charles, putting the team on his back there. The little 180 move around Howard. So the lead back up to three. Rotation to the right. Desmond O. Goldstein trying to flash through. Wong with the shot. It's going to be off the mark. Charles stepped in the lane to get the rebound. Back comes Bangkok. Goldstein, check that. The ball hog with the ball. O working on him. Thomas. Alexander. Wide open look. Fourth three of the game, or the half. That time, Piapon Perone, so they're queuing up for Bangkok. Fourth triple of the third quarter, and now the lead back up to six. Just when it looks like Singapore is going to get a full head of steam, back comes Bangkok, and it's a third different player to hit a three. Shot is off the mark. Charles, who else with another rebound? Kabahog now. We'll slow it down. Singapore gets back on defense. What can you say about Chris Charles? Thomas camped outside. Going straight at Howard. Wild shot off the mark. Alexander pulls that down. Quickly back comes Singapore and a foul. Let's see who that will go on. That'll be against number 9, Patrick Kabahub. If that is, I think that'll be 2 on him. Goldstein will check out of the game. Remember, he's got 3 fouls. Checking in will be Bandit Lockham. They don't lose a lot there. Lockham plays well against the Slingers. Desmond O with the ball now. Rosales quickly getting shut down by Lockham. Pushing and shoving. Rosales rises and fires. Let's see if that's a 2 or a 3. It'll be a 2, so 52-48. Chris Rosales with 19 points. Long working against Rosales, stepping up. Now Charles rolls to the basket. Let's see, a foul. It's going to be a blocking foul on Singapore. I thought for a moment might go against Charles. No such luck. So Wu will get called on the foul. That will be 3 on him. So Singaporeans in foul trouble. Number 2, O with 3, Wong with 3, Wu with 3, Howard with 3. The other side, the ball. Goldstein with 3. Kongkum with 3. Charles misses the front end of the 2 shot. Every time Singapore has come back at Bangkok, they have found somebody else to knock down a triple. First, it was Goldstein missing them both, and pulling down the ball is Alexander, still Alexander. Ball rotated to the right-hand side. Now the ball in the hands of Howard. Thomas will work on him. Alexander, wide open look for Wu on the left-hand side. Will miss it. Cleaned up by Howard, who can't put it back in. Nice job on defense by Piron. Back comes Bangkok. Running through the lane. Long shot by Kabahog is off the mark. Howard gets the ball over to Alexander. Alexander with Wu. Howard and a foul. And Howard has to be pushed away because that was a hard foul. Foul will go on number 13, Perone, and really putting his body to Justin Howard. Dangerous, dangerous play. Let's see if that is going to be a flagrant foul. They're not lining up like it is. Perone making Howard do it the hard way. He had an easy layup, as you could see there, and Perone coming in and smashing him with the body. Howard took exception to it. Desmond O had to block, Wu Chun-De had to block him out of the way. He was going to go at him, it looked like. Howard misses the first of two. Well, it's been that sort of a game, very physical. Bangkok has led almost all the way. Singapore keeps knocking at the door, but somebody always steps up for Bangkok. One of two, so 3-point game again. Checking it in will be Locken. Locken now from the pass from Thomas, looking downstairs. Perrone, Cabahog, in and out it goes. Rebound by Alexander. Thomas trying to stay with him. Desmond O camped out on the left-hand side, and on the floor goes Alexander. To the basket goes Wu. Cross-court pass. O back outside. Wide open look for Alexander. He's got to take that shot and can hit it. My goodness. Xavier Alexander jump shot travails continue here at OCBC Arena at the two-minute mark. Charles now. Howard working against him. Great move by Charles for two. 5-point lead now for Bangkok. Back come the Slingers. Rosales off the dribble. Howard, he'll take that shot. Little 11-footer is off the mark. So back come Bangkok. One and out again. Lockham now on the right-hand side looking for Charles downstairs. He hits him. Howard right there with him. Little pump fake. Charles with the post-up move. The spin is no good. Right into the path of Desmond O. Back come the Slingers. Off the dribble, still O. Forced his way inside. Counted in one. Desmond O. He will go to the line. What a job by Desmond O. Nose for the basket, going straight from A to B. Chance for Slingers to get to within two at the 125 mark of the third period. 2 on Perrone now. Well, wow. They are giving Xavier Alexander these outside shots all day long and just not able to knock him down. Be fair to the X-Man, that's not really his game. He is a slash and burn quintessential number 3 dribble penetrator and dish. Got it. So 2-point game now, 54-52. Back full court defense goes Singapore, getting the ball off to Goldstein, who's just checked back into the game. He's playing with 3 fouls. He'll back it up, spread it out a little bit, looking for Charles off the dribble. He goes, Goldstein, still Goldstein. Followed by Charles up and in. Chris Charles right there at the opposite side of the basket. Really feeling it, bounce pass over to, and what do we have here? Pushing inside, it'll be an offensive foul, and back to Bangkok it goes. So again, every time Singapore gets to within a couple of points, they shoot themselves in the foot. What about Chris Charles? Once again, having a monster game against the Slingers. 20 points. Goldstein working against Rosales now. Under a minute to go here in the third quarter. Crossover. Around the screen from Thomas. Alexander right there launches a long three off the mark right into the path of Rosales. He's off to the races. He'll hold it up a little bit. Stop. He'll pop from the elbow and he get it. 56-54. Singapore to within two. 4.5 seconds between game clock and shot clock. Goldstein barking out signals again, spreading out the offense. Rosales stays off of him. Back to Goldstein. Off the dribble now. Trying to get inside and the ball saved by Desmond O. Back comes Singapore. 4 seconds to go. Rotation to the right-hand side. Whoa! Can't get it. And that will do at the end of the third quarter. But Singapore getting back to within two. 56-54 with 10 minutes to go here at the OCBC Arena. Thank you.
And you have two shots in the mouth. Yo. Run. Shake it out, Rob. Shake it out.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Well, 10 more minutes of action to go. This crucial game one here at the OCBC Arena. Bangkok has led all the way. They lead the Slingers 56-54. And they've done it on the boards especially, but the big man, number 21, Chris Charles, 16 rebounds, 20 points, 4 offensive boards. And they've done it from downtown, 6-17 for 35%. Slingers, on the other hand, from beyond the arc, 1 of 11 for a pitiful 9%. So somebody's going to have to step up. Bangkok with the ball, locks him now. Working against Desmond O. Around him he goes. A long three. Got it. Just like we were talking about, from downtown again. So make it 7 of 18. And every time Singapore gets close, it's another one. In fact, that's only a 2-pointer, they say. Off the dribble, and they foul, and that will go on number 30, Nakorm Janasuk. So Singapore, 10 more minutes to get back in this thing. Remember, should Singapore lose, they will have to have the unenviable task of going to Bangkok for game two and play before that raucous crowd, the defending champions of Hi-Tech Bangkok City. Howard Thomas all over him. Dumps the ball off to Alexander. Charles can't stay with him, but the ball on the floor picked up by Bangkok. Back in the hands of Lockham. That's the way it's gone. Charles with the ball. Last touch by Bangkok, and Lockham throwing the ball away over the head of Charles. You can see what they're quickly trying to do. Get the ball over Alexander, but a little bit too ambitious with that pass. Rosales, he's been the hot hand for Singapore. 21 points for him. Wong comes out to get it. Howard inside, and the ball almost knocked away again. Rosales with 12 left on the shot clock will take the screen. Rotation, wide open look. Desmond O can't get it. He gets his own rebound, though, coming back the other way. Howard still at the high post. Alexander lurking. Howard will take that shot. Got it! Right around the free throw line. That is where he is so dangerous. Justin Howard, nobody coming out on him. 2-point game again. Lockham working against Wong. Thomas trailing it. Now he goes down to the low post. Up pops Chris Charles at the high post. Thomas again, he's working against Alexander. Post up move for him. Dunks his head down. The bull move inside. He gets his own rebound. Knocked away. Great play by Howard. Singapore on the move. Rosales off the dribble, lost it momentarily, trying to force the ball inside. The foul will go on Charles. Well, Wong really had no way to go. Charles reaches in with the foul anyway. That'll be 2 on the big man. Remember a couple of games ago, Chris Charles had 83-80 win for Singapore right here at the OCBC Arena. Chris Charles fouled out. It was after he fouled out, Singapore caught fire to win the game in overtime eventually. So Wong at the line. Chance to tie the game at 58 for Singapore. They've never led. Howard with 3 fouls. for Singapore. Nobody else really. Well, you've got all the three guards with three fouls, but at this point, at the 8-0-9 mark, pretty much academic. 2 of 2, so 58 apiece. Usually this is the part where Bangkok comes cruising back with somebody hitting a three. Let's see if Singapore comes out a little bit further and puts a hand in the shooter's faces. They can't afford to do that too much with the weapons that Bangkok has downstairs. Goldstein working on that right-hand side. Kabahog turns, fires, got it. He has been good. Patrick Kabahog, he was a vital cog for this team last year. Off the dribble. Now the ball in the hands of Wong. He'll back it back out again, being hassled by Goldstein. The rotation to Rosales. Up pops Howard. Thomas working on him. He throws the screen. Rosales at the top of the key. Yes. Ties it up at 60. 7:36 to go. Chris Rosales continuing to fire away. 23 points for him. Ball knocked away. Lockham barely evading the turnover. Rosales. Pressure defense by Singapore. Rotation over to Charles. Trying to dump it into Howard. A push from behind. Let's see who that goes against. If it's Howard, it'll be four on him. Let's see. Desmond O. So that'll be four on Desmond. He has been one of the spark plugs, especially on defense. A lot of times his contributions not appreciated as much as they should be off the dribble. Here comes Alexander, losing the ball to Lockham. Back the other way comes Bangkok. The ball in the hands of Kabahog, who fills it up off the glass. Good job by Bangkok in transition. They lead by two. Wong. Rosales back over to Wong. Wide open look. Plugged off at the baseline. Inside goes Alexander for the two. Got to step on Charles. That doesn't happen often. So tied up at 62, 6:35 to go. Lockham around Wong. Thomas trailing the play. Lockham again. Has the ball knocked away. Picked up by Alexander. Two on one. Lead pass to Wong. Back to Alexander. Falling down and a foul will go on who? It'll go on Thomas. That'll be four on him. Technical foul on Thomas. Technical foul on Thomas. The referee standing his ground. Thomas better watch. He's about ready to get another one. Crucial play in the game, perhaps, right there. Thomas now with three fouls, plus picking up the technical. So Stephen Thomas now with four fouls. Wow. What a turn of events. Cannot lose your temper. So let's see how this will shake out. I believe Singapore will get three shots plus the ball. Stephen Thomas, up in this to this point, have been the rock for Bangkok. What an error on his part, losing his composure. Still barking at the referee. So Rosales, I believe, will shoot two. Kabahog trying to calm things down. And Rosales hits the first. That's 24. Okay, so one shot in the ball. So Singapore forging their first lead of the game, 63-62. Thomas now playing with four fouls. Let's see, off the dribble, who's that going to be on? I think that's going to go on number 12, Bandit Lockin, and Howard getting the guys together and talking about, hey, let's not lose our composure. So Wu will go to the line to shoot a pair. Well, well, well. You hate to see a game decided by something like this, but at the same point, you've got to remain calm and composed under pressure, and this is what is not happening thus far with the Hi-Tech City Bangkok. Thomas losing it, and then Lockham losing it. So two right there. So a three-point lead now for Singapore. Bangkok will call timeout. Slingers lead, their biggest lead of the game, 65-52 at the timeout. 6:16 to go here at the OCBC Arena. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. What a turn of events here at the OCBC Arena. Singapore Slingers lead the Hi-Tech Bangkok City team 65-62. It all started with a technical foul on Steve Thomas. Chris Rosales calmly stepping up and knocking that down, and then another intentional foul. Wu Chin De knocking those two down. Now Singapore with the ball out of bounds, a chance to stretch the lead even further. This already the biggest lead of the game. Bangkok is led by as many as eight. Long now, around one screen. He'll take that long three, is going to be short. Rebound, stepping in is Lockham to intercept that. Back comes Goldstein. Long three by him is going to ring off and on. Thomas, or check that, Howard with the rebound. This Charles hassling him. Inside, they ought to go right at Thomas, and there was that shot again by Howard off the mark that time. Charles ripping down the board. 21st rebound, I think, for Chris Charles. Goldstein now, 5:36 here to go in the game. Charles outside. He'll take that long shot for two. Wow. Chris Charles showing he can hit from outside as well. 1-point game, and that gets the crowd back down to normal decibel level. Alexander now gives it off to Wu. Howard on the right-hand side. Now running to the back, and a foul, a pushy foul. Let's see who that will go against. That might be Goldstein. If it is, that will be four on him. Yes, that is four on him. So Thomas with four, Goldstein with four. Long at the line, chance to get Singapore up by three. Bangkok losing their composure a little bit, going down the stretch here in the fourth quarter in a game that you don't want to say they had total control over, because they didn't, but always seeming to find a way to keep their nose ahead. And Wong misses the first of two. Anxious crowd here at the OCBC Arena. Chuck Schreiner with you, hoping you're enjoying it. Wherever you are, game one of these semifinals, Hi-Tech Bangkok City and the Singapore Slingers here at the OCBC Arena. Oh, knocked out of the cylinder, and no call there, so 0-2. Lockham. Long working on him. Up pops Goldstein. Goldstein and Rosales going at it, rolling to the basket, up and in. So back in the lead, go Hi-Tech. Good job off the dribble by Freddie Goldstein. Under 5 minutes to go. Wu back outside to Alexander. Rolling to the basket, knocked away. Last touch by who? Saved. Lockham coming back. Charles racing down to the other end of the court. Let's see if they try and get him the ball. A foul. That'll go against Singapore. A push. So that'll go against Wu. And that'll be four on him. Getting ready to check in for Wu will be Desmond Oh, who is also playing with four fouls. A lot of players with foul trouble hanging over their head here late in the game. Hi-Tech has been their habit tonight, coming back when they need a basket the most. Freddie Goldstein rolling to the hoop. He's got 12 now. Charles, he's been the man tonight. Thomas down the low post. Alexander watching him. Goldstein off the dribble, looking for separation. He gets it. He fires it up. Off the mark, stepping in to get the rebound is Wong. He's got Rosales ahead of him. Wong busting through. Oh, the ball thrown away. Desmond O can't corral it. A turnover at the 4:06 mark. Bangkok will get it back. Chance to go up by more than one now. Lockham checking it into Goldstein. Rosales will work on him. Flashing to the right is number 9, Hubba Hub. Thomas. Alexander working on him. Still Thomas. Turns, fires. Got it! Beautiful shot by Thomas. A little fadeaway. Can't afford to be too aggressive. Now Bangkok back up by 3. Inside to Howard. Howard has Rosales. Rosales will stop and pop from the left side. No good. Rebound who else but Charles. Charles with the ball now. 3:28 to go. Bangkok wind in their sails at the moment. The Bahub down low to Charles. Charles going digging straight for the basket. Has to kick it back outside to Bahub. Right around Desmond. Go. The ball taken away. 3-on-1. Lead pass to Desmond O. Oh, yes, for the finish. 68-67. On the defense again. Singapore Slingers getting it done. Under 3 minutes to go. Charles. They'll be leaning on him. Still Charles. Off balance shot. That will send Kabahub to the line for 2. So a chance for Bangkok to go back up by 3. Desmond O, that will be 5 on him. He will leave the game. And who knows, this may be the last time we see him until next season. Marvelous year for Desmond O, especially on the defensive end. Tonight he will go out 10 points. So Wu will come back into the game. Wu with 4 fouls as well. So Kabahub, integral part of the same Bangkok team last year, fills it up. So 2-point lead now for Hi-Tech City. Singapore briefly had a 3-point lead, but turn around, and now it is Bangkok with a 2-point lead. Rebound taken by Howard. Outlet pass to Rosales. He's got Wu camped out on the right-hand side. He gets the ball to him. Now to Howard. Howard looking for Alexander. Alexander on the low post. Rotation to the right. Wong now with the ball, looking for the screen. He is double-teamed. Inside to Howard, corrals it. And what do we have here? Did he step on the inbound line? Yes, he did. No, he didn't. A foul, and that will go on number 9, Kabahub. Gets caught in the mismatch down low there with Justin Howard. Nice job by Wong to find Howard, by the way. So a chance now for the Slingers to tie it up at the 2:25 mark. Nobody has left their seats here at the OCBC Arena. Best crowd we've had of the year. So Singapore trying to take the 1-0 lead to ensure, in worst case scenario, another trip here, and Howard misses a first of 2. So Singapore not hitting their 3-point shots and faltering at the line here down the stretch. 1 of 2, so 1-point lead now by Hi-Tech. So Singapore needing to stop, employ the full court press. Ball to Thomas, now back to number 12, Locking. Rotates to Thomas. Thomas will wait for numbers, gets the ball in the hands of Goldstein. He has been the danger man. 12 points tonight here for little Freddie. Thomas, crunching screen by him, gets inside. The little fade, got it to go. So 3-point lead again, and you can sort of see that happening. See the play developing. Goldstein getting around the screen, a cruncher delivered by Thomas, getting the separation that he needed. Back outside to Wong, under 2 minutes to go now. Wu Other side now. Six left on the shot clock. Howard back outside it goes. Little fadeaway shot. Yes. Muchinda hitting perhaps his biggest shot of the season right there. 71-70, 137 to go. Again, full court pressure by Singapore. Lachlan again. Yo-yoing across the half court line. He'll be looking for Goldstein on the right. Falling down, the ball punched away. Who's gonna get to it first? Goldstein, no. Back court violation, it'll be Singapore ball. Well, Goldstein lost possession of it. Had 1 foot across the line and 1 foot back, so break for Singapore again. Getting it done on the defensive end. Now let's see what they can do offensively. Trailing by a point with 1:24 to go. Alexander will check it in on the far sidelines. See how they'll draw this up. Wong to Alexander, goes straight to the basket, and he is fouled. I think that'll go on Charles, and if it is, that'll be number three on Chris. Not a bad foul, really, when you think about it, but Singapore fans responding to Justin Howard, trying to pump up the crowd. Alexander will be at the line, where he has been less than stellar this year. So he'll be asked to knock down both to put Singapore in the lead with 1:20 to go. We have timeouts going to be called by Bangkok. So 71-70, Hi-Tech City with a 1 point lead with 1:20 to go, and Alexander at the line when we come back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. In fact, that foul was on number 9, Patrick Kabahub, and what a revelation he was for Bangkok today. All he did was pump in 13 points, 3 assists, 3 rebounds, but he is gone. So it was not on Chris Charles. Alexander, the pressure squarely on his shoulders at the line, will be expected to knock down 2 shots. There is Freddie Goldstein. What a job he's done today for Bangkok Hi-Tech City. 14 points. He's also playing with 4 fouls. Very brave Bangkok team who has come into the Lions Den. Remember, they are without Dasan Wadapong. They're without Tyler Lamb. So doing it with a pickup of Kabahub and other local guys who have more than done their job. But can they hang on for the last minute and 20 and get out of here with the win? And get the series back over to their place with a 1-0 lead, putting Singapore's back to the wall. Alexander at the line. Misses the first one, back rims it. And
one.
Thomas playing with 4 fouls. We'll switch sides to match up against Howard. We'll put Charles in box out mode in case the ball misses. Misses them both. Charles with the rebound. So grievous misses for Singapore going down the stretch. You cannot miss your free throws in situations like this. Goldstein working against Rosales. They'll spread it out. Look for the ball to get to Charles. Alexander watching him. Oh, beautiful spin move. Inside he goes. And the ball is thrown away. 1 minute to go. Well, Goldstein, great job to get separation, but got inside, and Bangkok guilty of ball watching. Throwing a pass to nobody. The ball out of bounds. He was expecting Charles to rotate towards the ball. He did not. So another kick at the can for Singapore. Let's see if they try and get the ball downstairs to Howard. Still a 1-point game. Back comes Wong. Thomas working on Howard. Lockham now to Alexander. Alexander, Howard. Can't get it to go right into the path of Lockham, and they foul in the backcourt. So that will send Bangkok to the line. Chance to go up by three with 40.5 to go, and those missed free throws by Alexander looming large right now. See, what do we have here? Lockham will check it in. Bangkok coach coming off of the bench and barking some sort of instructions. So Lockham, see if they'll try and get the ball to Goldstein and dribble penetration, dump the ball off to Charles. That would be one alternative, and the Bangkok coach is better be careful. He's going to get himself in trouble. He finally goes off the court. Could have gotten a technical foul there. You never want a game to be decided like that. So the ball in Bangkok's court right now. They can get a bucket here and make it extremely difficult for Singapore. Goldstein, Charles downstairs, Alexander on him. They'll try to eat time off the clock. Goldstein still off the dribble. Nearly dropped it. Three is going to be way off the mark, and out of bounds it goes. Five left on the shot clock when that happened. 21.3, so Singapore can play for the last shot. Timeout on the court by the Slingers. They trail 71-70 with 21-3 left to go here. Game one of the semifinals of the OCBC Arena. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. 21.3 seconds to go for Singapore. They try to come from behind. 71-70, they trail. And the dilemma for Singapore is, yeah, you want to score, but you don't want to leave too much time on the clock. Give the magician, Fred Goldstein, a chance to do his magic and perhaps rotate the ball down to Chris Charles, who's been almost unstoppable every time he's come into OCBC Arena. Let's see what the plan will be. Alexander will inbound it. Perhaps try to get the ball in the hands of Howard. If he is fouled, he'll go to the line and see how fast this particular play will develop. Bangkok coach still jawing with the referee on the sidelines. He better be very careful. He's been told again to get off the court. And another timeout by Bangkok. They want to talk it over again, so burning all their timeouts, perhaps trying to put a freeze job on Singapore. We'll stay with you. So a lot of scenarios. I would think that they might, if you're Bangkok, you want the ball in one of the outside shooters' hands. Singapore has not been good at all from beyond the arc today. That on three-point shots after three quarters anyway. Singapore has been 1 of 11 from beyond the arc. They missed one this quarter, too, so 1 of 12. And that has been a big plus for Bangkok today. They've always found somebody to hit the long shot, to hit the troika. Singapore, not so much, and really, that has been one of Singapore's main weapons this year, but not today. That and losing Justin Howard for most of the first half. All credit to Singapore defense keeping Singapore in the game. They only trailed by four at the end of the half. But Bangkok, the continues to just chip away at you. They're a sort of a team, even when they're shorthanded. They've got enough power to keep it close, and that's what they've done to the point where they lead by one. Remember, this is a team that is playing without two of their starters. So they somehow found a way to get it done. Xavier Alexander had destiny in his hands. He could have hit free throws a couple of minutes ago to get Singapore the lead. He couldn't knock him down. And a couple of turnovers on the other side of the ball, too. So turnabout fair play. Wong rolling off of the screen. Got to get the ball to him. They do. 18 to go here. Wong off the dribble. He will dribble penetrate. Howard will take the shot from that right side. He'll miss it. Rebound by Bangkok. They have the ball. 7 seconds to go. You've got to foul him. They do. Wong, a hard foul on number 12, Bandit Lockin, and that might just do it. Howard can't knock down the shot. A really disjointed effort by the Slingers off of that out-of-bounds play. Wong got the ball. Dribbled to the top of the key. And the only guy that was open was Howard, a little bit out of his range, about a 15-foot jumper. So Lockham, with 5:07 to go, a chance to put it away now for Bangkok if he can knock them both down. Remember, he hit a huge three in the game that Singapore barely escaped 83-80 when Charles fouled out. So Bangkok on the cusp of coming here and doing what a lot of people didn't think they would do, especially with the injuries to their team, surviving and able to take the game to their house on Friday for all the marbles when they can wrap up this series. Now let's see what Lockham can do with the free throws. Not over yet. Got the first one, so there's your 2-point lead. So one more will make it very difficult for Singapore. They will have to hit a three, and they'll have to do it with 5.7 on the clock remaining. Got them both. So timeout by Singapore. They'll talk it over and get the ball back on their side of the court. They trail 73-70 with 5.7 to go in the game. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, on the timeout still. Remember, this is a situation Singapore and Bangkok have been in before. If you remember that 83-80 overtime win that Singapore got about five or six weeks ago. They thought they had it won, Bangkok did. They had a 1-point lead with 1.8, or a 3-point lead with 1.8 to go. Chris Rosales tying it up at the buzzer, sending it into overtime, and Singapore held on and won the game. Singapore hoping it's deja vu all over again. So somehow they're going to have to rub someone off the screen and get an open look at the three. Kwek is in the game now. He is a three-point specialist, but it has not been the Slingers' day as far as three-point shots go. They've only made one. On one side of the ball, you could say they are due. They have three prospective three-point shooters in the game right now. Alexander is going to inbound it, so Singapore will have one kick at the can. Outside look. Rosales will have to pump it up. Shot is off the mark, and Bangkok will win. Bangkok wins game one of the semifinals, 73-70. What an effort coming in here again, shorthanded, without Wadapalm, without Lamb. The Chris Charles show, but not just him. Goldstein also, 14 points by him. Don't forget the replacement player, Patrick Kabaha, chipping in with 13 points. He fouled out, but had enough in the tank to help Singapore, or to help Bangkok, overcome the home court advantage that Singapore enjoyed. Remember, Singapore without the services of Howard for much of the first half because he had three fouls. Howard finishes with 12 points. He had a good second half, but not enough. Singapore not knocking down their three-point shots and not hitting their free throw shots down the stretch These are the things you need to do if you expect to be a champion. So Singapore, their backs will be up against the wall when they go to Bangkok on Friday for game two. One more loss when they're out of it, and they are going into the champion's den. Hi-Tech Bangkok City, a 1-0 lead. They can wrap it up on Friday. If they do not, we will have a game three here in Singapore, right here next Sunday at 4 o'clock. That's Singapore time here at the OCBC Arena. Final score again, Hi-Tech Bangkok City 73, Singapore Slinger 70. For all the production staff here, this is Chuck Schreiner saying so long for now.